I was listening yesterday to the, but it was very hard to understand.
The sound. It's better from the computer with earphones.
Ah, okay.
I know this problem because of the acoustics also.
Is it possible? No.
Italian?
Ah, Italian.
No, I'm Greek, but I speak Italian and
so. Ah, okay. Yeah. Oh, wow. That's a friend. Are there more Greek people
we
here?
We have three performers.
I mean, more Greek visitors?
No, I haven't noticed such a big one.
Is there still something to see in Athens?
No, it has finished.
Yeah, I know, but can you see in the pub?
I don't know, I'm here.
Photos in between.
Thank you.
cares?
How many people in this room wear a colorful necklace? Does the woman who is seated in the corner of the room wear glasses?
Yes.
Yes.
How many people wear glasses?
5, 6, 4, 9.
How many people wear black?
Several. In this room?
Generally today.
Into
how many people do do you personally know inside this room?
One.
Do you met someone with an open heart?
Yes.
Nobody.
Does this experience really pay back the money you paid to experience it?
No.
Yes.
Why?
Yes, in the sense of energy and creativity. For my daily life at home.
Who's getting tired of standing?
Thank you.
We can open our eyes now, and we can do two groups, people who like this performance and people who didn't like this. So at the left part of the room, they're going to be the people who didn't like it and the people who liked it from this side.
Like,
dislike.
It doesn't matter for me. So I don't dislike it. I don't like it. I'm not unsure.
Okay,
so where do I
go?
Can you explain to the people who liked it why this was shit? Would you like to tell us?
Huh?
Would you like to express yourself? Why?
Yeah, for me it was too many orders. I got into a mood of no.
Fuck you.
Yeah, it's mainly that.
Maybe it's not easy to say.
Maybe we should convince them.
I don't think it's necessary.
We can take them over to us.
Ah. Well, that's the logic of two groups, isn't it?
Yeah, it would be nice.
Depends on us.
I think it's a new experience. I think it's interesting.
I think it's fantastic fascination, because you can remember for the thing. I've seen the things, but I don't remember for it in this moment. It is fascination, I think. It's a feeling in this room.
And it somehow got me into thinking that I didn't really manage to be here, because if I had really managed to be here at all, I would have known at least more answers, and that in many aspects I'm still somewhere else.
Kann mich jemand übersetzen?
Ja.
Danke. Ich finde es eine sehr mutige, ein mutiges Projekt.
It's a very encouraging project, or
brave
project.
So viele fremde Menschen zu zu bringen, aufeinander zu achten.
So many strange persons to be considered.
Looking for one another.
Yeah.
So we're gonna do another group, another division into groups. People who feel instrumentalized and people who don't feel instrumentalized. So instrumentalized are from here, non-instrumentalized there. Free. So?
I thought that group was not like. I don't like it because I feel. I didn't expect something like this. I felt cheated. I felt we were asked to do something that we weren't.
So why did you stay?
Because my husband is here.
Ah, okay.
I thought we were
here. It's the door is open. You can leave whenever you want.
I just want to wait for
him. Okay. The people that they feel free, they're not instrumentalized.
In this game, you say, not in their life.
In this game you were, but in the life you're not. Have we read the score? Shall we read the score loud? Would you like?
Prepare the audience with concepts, questions, and movements as a way to explore the dissonance that exists between the individual narcissism that capitalism promotes and our social capacity, between how we conceive ourselves as free individuals with agency and the way that we are socially determined by capitalist relations, technology, and ideology. Reflect on the I-we relation while defining social dissonance. Help the collective subject to emerge.
Instrumentalized are those also who didn't like the experience?
No, not necessarily.
We like to be instrumentalized.
Why didn't you say no?
It was not frightening for me.
Mm-hmm. Actually, I'm a little bit jealous of your line.
Now you must stay here and I can go out.
So what do you think? We should get instrumentalized or avoid getting instrumentalized? What we should do?
Individuality and should change into a collective being. This doesn't sound good.
To whom does it? Maybe for how many people does it not listen good? They feel it's not good as.
Let's make two categories, people who feel that individualism is a bad thing and people who believe that individualism is a good thing. Sorry, can we speak one by one?
It is too general. General, this question. Mm-hmm. Sometimes you have to be an individual, and sometimes you have to fit into a group. So you have to abandon your to put behind you your individuality. Therefore, I think you cannot say who is for, who is against. Yeah. It's both.
Individuals.
Yeah. It was interesting to see during the performance that there are a long time when mostly all of us woke in the same direction, like sheep or cows or humans who march in the same purpose. Most. Yeah.
But it all started laughing or smiling if you look at the eyes.
Yeah.
Mm.
Yeah.
And in the same rhythm.
Yeah.
But this is not a sign of collectivity, is it to you?
No.
Was there any sign of collectivity?
Collectivity is a thing that has to be to do with same interests, same ideas, a certain same heartbeat, and not this is artificial collectivity.
I think we feel a little bit collective or like a collectivity when we started putting these groups together. Then I was looking around myself and noticing, they are thinking the same as I do.
But I think a good group or a good collectivity is that keeps the individuals as individuals and doesn't make them only one aspect of themselves.
I think, for example, I'm a rather individual, and it's difficult to find a collectivity that suits me. But if I do find one, it's a great feeling. It's a great feeling. You don't have it so often if you really feel like a collectivity.
Mm-hmm. I think we are a group that today is the same moment looks for, but not a collective. We are a group with individual, and we do the experience. That I think. But I think the same what you say, it's not a collective. Yes, I think so too.
I have to say that the most connected moment with people in this room were when we had to have deep eye contact. It was like this moment we stared in each eyes and it was like a little smile there, and that was like the moment where I felt connected to people. So for me, and this was the most impact moment. So I rather than know anybody new, and that was like a nice feeling, and that was like the collective moment where like the where I have to feel like
I find the collective moment of this experience when we think all together, maybe when we are struggling to understand what has happened, and we have, but when we start to talk, it dissolves. I think different opinions come up, like people want to reaffirm and say, okay, it's like this or it's like that, and I think the collective thing is the silence.
But it is important to remember this is just a game. No matter what we feel today, it's all artificial. The real community is not here. The real community is where we actually live. So no matter how much positivity we feel towards one another here, we go our separate ways. We might not speak to one another anymore, and we might not recognize one another outside this hall. So that's the most important thing to remember. This is only an exercise.
I don't agree. I don't agree at all. I think it's such a beautiful moment if you feel, like he said, like a collectivity. I think it's a good good thing to remember, that like silent or looking at the eyes, that these feeling things or heart things make us more as a collectivity than speaking about it. but I don't agree that it's virtual, that it's artificial, and that's only just do it now, live in the moment. Don't think about tomorrow when you are back in your town or in your country.
I'm not saying that this is not good. I'm not saying that this is not good. I'm saying that this is not where we live.
Mm-hmm. But we can create a collectivity here and now, and just be here and now. That's what I'm supposed
to say. Yes, actually, to me, the interesting part is to observe in this hour, which is, of course, a very specific structure that we have here. This is not, of course, a community that we are part of. But maybe the interesting part is to try to analyze in a way and to see which are the characteristics that actually make it harder for us to be a collective in a way. And for example, I think today we tried to investigate how our lack of having, as you said, our lack of having, of being present, maybe is one of the things that makes us feel apart from one another. I'm saying it in a very abstract way, of course, but to me it was interesting in the first part that the answers were so wrong most of the times, and that we really didn't pay so much attention to the environment or to the people inside the space. And to me this is very connected to the way we live, and the way we live gives us so much input every day that we cannot really analyze and understand and take. It gives us more than we can take. And maybe this is one of the reasons that we really don't spend enough time also in our everyday life and in our real communities to understand and to connect with people that we actually live together. So maybe this is a connection that we can find.
We don't hear that.
Yeah.
They don't hear.
I'm saying that maybe not the answers were wrong, but the questions. Because all the questions were about the what you generally understand as architecture, the fixtures, the windows, the doors. There was nothing about the texture of the wall. There was nothing about how the floor looks like. There was nothing about the cracks. Not everyone observes the same things. So you kind of focused your questions just one route. And I think that's possibly... It felt stuck, at least for me. That's why I got stuck myself.
Did you yourself realize that most of your questions was about numbers?
Mm.
How many, how much, how many,
mm.
how many?
Mm.
And I think this way to ask is also a capitalistic way to see the world, to ask in this world.
And superficial things about necklaces and who cares?
Yeah.
Yes.
What would you have asked? I mean, it's this room. It has that much to give. And for me, for example, I looked at the rooms. I really did. And I actually really counted them. But it was such a small time of concentration because I went to something else so fast that I completely forgot how many windows there were. Actually, I did count them, but I said the wrong number afterwards. So that was what I was trying to say before, that I was not actually here, and that if I would have been here, maybe of course not all of the answers about numbers, because it's impossible to see how many classes we have if we don't count them. It's a too high number. It's just not possible.
Walls, there are walls, and there are two gray walls. Is it a wall? What is a wall for
And I think the question that is possible to have asked, you are happy to stay here, or have you a good feel in this room? Yes and no, where possible to say. It's
so
not
this
long.
Is about you.
It's about
your feeling.
Yes, yes,
yourself.
Yes, but it's different. In this room, a lot of people, and this feeling is different. But you can ask it, and a lot of people can say, yes, I feel good here. If you feel good here in this room, you can say yes or no.
Yes, but the question is not about you trying to see something outside. It's
okay.
About you, how you feel inside you. But anyway, of course,
yes,
of course, the questions were capitalistic questions, of course. I mean, what else would they be? Possibly. But to me, also I was not able to count how many glasses we have in the room. It is, in a way, I don't know, symbolic, I guess.
But we hit the title of this very well, didn't
Social
we?
Dissonance.
Yeah, exactly. We had one question and everybody had another answer about it.